company is dedicated to keeping others safe from ATV accidents.
4029's Lauren Limerick shows us how they're building a safer ride for all of us.
According to the U.S. Consumer Product Safety Commission, Arkansas has one of the highest numbers of deaths associated with ATV accidents in the country.
We at least work two or three deaths every year contributed to ATVs, and unfortunately in the past, most of those deaths have been young people, teenagers.
The Engineering Institute in Farmington wants to change that.
The problem with an ATV is that it's unstable in a turn. It's all of the worst characteristics of a vehicle rolled into one compact package.
And when you add speed and inexperience to the mix, the outcome is often tragic. Dr. David Winfro says ATVs are deceiving.
They look safe, but they're not. And the reason why is because they respond in many different ways for the same set of inputs. This is not a predictable machine.
Now look at these examples. First, an ATV that is on the market right now with a rollover bar added for the demonstration.
He's trying to stay close to the cones, but the rear end spins out, and when it does, it gets sideways and it rolls over.
Now check out the Institute's redesigned ATV going through the same cones at the same speed.
Watch how close he's able to keep the vehicle to the cones. And that is all because the steering or the suspension system is made and designed where you get this nice handling characteristic.
Dr. Renfro says the design changes keep the ATV fun, but far less dangerous.
We have a lot of children who are being injured and dying on an ATV. The parent looks at the vehicle and says, oh, they can put them on there, four-wheel stable, and they can drive. It doesn't drive like a normal vehicle. And therefore, it should, and it can, if you just institute a few simple changes.
Lauren Limerick, 4029 News.
Not only has the Institute designed a new ATV, they've partnered with doctors at Arkansas Children's Hospital to teach parents about the dangers of ATVs.